Ich mag deinen Anblick und dass du viele Sprachen sprichst.
Meisterschaft in diesem Jahr gespielt, stand im Achtelfinale und war einer der 9 Contender in der Premier League Darts. Hollywood Chris Doby! Chris Doby nimmt es auf mit der aktuellen Nummer 3 der Welt. Er steht so hoch im Ranking wie noch nie in seiner Karriere. Hat das 2. European Tour Turnier in diesem Jahr von Hildesheim gewinnen können. Es war sein erster Erfolg auf der European Tour. Er ist der World Grand Prix Champion von 2017 aus Nordirland. Super Chin, Daryl Gurney!
Touching warm, reaching out, touching me, touching you.
Kirkulator, Kirk Bevans.
But they've ceased, so we can get on with game 3 of the night here at the European Darts Grand Prix. And it sees one of only 2 winners on the Euro Tour so far this year. Daryl Gurney, winner of the German Darts Championship, taking on Chris Doby, who was superb yesterday in his opening win against Matters Rasmer. A 6-0 whitewash with an average of 103.5. If he reproduces that, even the players' champion and a man who is potentially closing in on a first ever appearance at the Premier League playoffs, it might be too much for him. But do not rule out Super Chin in any situation. This is a man who has beaten Michael van Gerwen 3 times in a row, although he did lose the most recent one. It should be said, though, he had chances. He could have made it 4 in a row. And that is something that nobody has managed to do since MBG became a major champion.
It's Chris to throw first. Game on.
Doby has the advantage of throwing first. I have the dubious advantage of commentating with Chris Murphy.
There's an advantage, Dan. As I make how do we know he can?
43.
Because we're psychic, Merv. He's averaged 110 in a final.
108!
I prefer the psychic line. Gurney beat Doby en route to that Players' Championship.
58.
Glory. In fact,
thrashed him, didn't he?
Yeah, 10-2 in the quarterfinals.
104.
The time he beat him was also in the Players' Championship and finals the previous year in the last 16. Derby has two wins against Darrell, but both of those came on the floor.
One of them recently, though, did
45,
beat him.
45, only 84.
Pro Tour event in Wigan earlier this year. But this is going to make it 1-0 against the Thrive.
Game's on the
first
leg.
That's an 11-dart leg from Superchip.
Second leg is Darrell to throw first. Game.
I have to give credit to Darrell for the way that he's dealt with the afters, after the afters, after the match on Thursday night, because he's come out, apologised, end of story.
96.
We'll see. Price and Gurney could clash in the final this weekend.
The way that Gerwin Price played earlier on, he's going to take some stopping.
Yeah, well, it's been a real mixed bag, hasn't it, for the players that are going to be involved in the mix in the Premier League, because James Wayne decided not to come to Germany this weekend. Gerwin Price produced a brilliant performance against Calvin Carlin, and Rob Cross has been sent crashing out.
Well, Rob Cross said that his best preparation for Thursday, and indeed the playoffs, where he knows he's going to be, it's just whether he goes there as league winner, is to be playing darts and playing well and winning games. Well, that's not gone well for him this weekend. But this is going very, very well for Darrell Gurney.
It is. Still Mensah Suljovic to come. He takes on Steve Beaton, a man he's only beaten once in his career.
108!
Derby follows a 1-7-1.
94.
Of course, MVG up against Gurney's World Cup partner.
Double 18. Hey, where's he gone?
78. Which will go 138.
Did he?
Yeah, he miscounted, didn't he, Darrell, there?
Well, if he was going for tops, it's a good job he missed.
He had 94 when he approached the hockey, and he thought that four had somehow scored zero.
98. Dalia Maguire, 16.
Well, he does like it in this part of the board.
He knew what he was doing. Didn't he? Didn't he? No, he had 12. No idea. Made a right mess of it.
Richard Maguire, 40.
Well, Chris Dobie was lagging.
He'll be laughing in a minute.
Chris Dobie.
Well,
third leg
brain
is Chris
freeze
to throw first.
From Super Chip. Allowing Derby in.
Well, what I feel, like, as much as I think that that is
96.
Funny, it's always funny if somebody miscounts, if they hit the double and celebrate and then get told that it's too many or not enough. That's the peak miscount.
95.
Surely the world number three has never done that.
$134.
Been a few famous ones of that, haven't there? A lot of them involving Devon Peterson.
Yeah, Big Devon is absolutely world class at it.
$137.
Steve Farmer famously celebrating a 180. Ali Pally then being told no score.
98.
Stupendous. Needs to make sure he leaves a finish here. Let's have no more silly mathematics.
137.
Still a quite brilliant performance from Darrell, despite the madness at the end of the last leg. Yes, he made a mistake. Oh, he's got to follow that in, hasn't he? Look at that.
Oh.
92.
Well, he is looking Richard very likely,
78.
Isn't he?
It could be in Mervyn King territory here of playing quite ridiculously good darts and finding himself behind.
Bullseye.
53.
Now this time,
40.
You want tops, Darrell.
Games on the third leg, Darrell Gurney.
Well, the finishing was very, very good from Darrell Gurney on Thursday night, and it kept him in the game against Gerwin Price, who did look like the better player for large chunks of it. Had to survive a match dart, but his destiny is still in his own hands in the Premier League. And his destiny is still very much in his own hands in this one. So a wild one. But he is looking very, very good, Super Chin.
He really is. And it will be
93.
A very good warm-up for Thursday night's match against Michael Smith.
Look at that first night. I know we're only in the
96.
Fourth leg, but Ryan Searle looking on. Ryan Searle safely through to the final day, of course, having beaten Glenn Durrant yesterday, and with James Wade withdrawing from the tournament at the very last minute. It means that Heavy Metal goes straight through to the last 16. He will face either Mensah or Steve Beaton. That game follows this one. Ryan Searle will be an interested spectator in that, no doubt.
Yeah, the winner of this taking on the winner of a real standout tie later this evening between Max Hopp and Nathan Aspinall.
140. Daniel Guay, 170.
From Derby here on the gurney throw. He's not going to take out 170.
99. Chris Dubois, 128.
So, treble 18. And another.
Always difficult there, wasn't it? The lie didn't look perfect for him to follow it. Thought maybe he might look at the treble 14.
88. Daryl Uguar, 71.
Doesn't work out for him. Single 18 for Tops.
51. Chris Uguar, 40.
Double top to break the throw. Have to give credit to Chris for clinging on.
Okay, he does cling on. Christo.
Well, the second time he's taken out 40.
Game on.
We're going 20 and double 10, and we've had four consecutive breaks of throw. And look at that. 11 darter and a trio of 14 darters. Really top quality stuff.
108.
And it is not stopping.
80.
Gurney is in
133.
He's reached the semi-finals in the last two tournaments in which he's played, including last weekend in Austria when he lost out to MVG. And
100.
Players' Championship on the Sunday, lost out to Willie O'Connor in the semis, but Gurney only played on the Sunday.
That was the Wednesday, wasn't it?
Oh, sorry, yes. The midweek.
140.
But yes, the second day of the two.
Yes. Decision travelling back from the previous event, decided not to enter the first day when some other Premier League players opted out of the Wednesday. It seemed to do the trick for Darrell, but yeah, Derby's done the trick here.
Seems like it's down to throw first. Game on.
Hold of throw. 12 darter with Gurney. Not even halfway down from 5.01. That's the first hold of throw we've seen in this
134.
Game. Both men averaging in excess of a ton. We've seen this before today. James Richardson overcame Mervyn King despite both firing in ton plus averages. Well, Dobie's actually dropped a little, but it's a roundabout there. Christoph Ratajski loses with an average of almost 102 earlier on.
60.
The first game of the day, in fact. Michael Smith, the man who did for him. Again, a mixed bag for the guys in the Premier League. And, of course, it is Michael Smith who faces Gurney on Thursday.
100.
Yeah, it's been a mixed bag, actually, for the seeded players in this tournament. Because so far through to the last 16, we have five seeds and five qualifiers.
93.
Gurney in a handy spot to tie it up at three each.
60.
However, he was unable to adjust from that first dart there. And Dobie might be sniffing blood a little bit. Needs to find at least one treble.
59. Daniel 154.
So often you see that where one player presents a chance and then the other player 56. Just tightens up a little bit, knowing that this could be a big shot.
Well, this could be a big shot.
And you'd rather have 96 than 98.
98 and throwing, or 96 and waiting?
98 and throwing. Sorry, I meant 96.
74. Chris Yuguan, 96.
Gurney will have to wait on 24 and watch and hope for a miss from Chris. But Dobie does not miss.
Chris Dobie. So
now
Chris
we've
to
seen
throw
the
first.
World number two
on.
Depart the scene. Is the world number three about to follow?
Three legs on the spin for the man from Bedlington.
95.
Looking to make it three wins against Darrell Gurney and his second this year.
60.
Yeah, Darrell Gurney against Michael Van Gerwen this year. Played 3-1-2. Could be Darrell Gurney against Chris Dobie this year. Played 2, lost 2.
Just looked a little bit out of sorts throwing there. Gurney kind of walked forward and looked annoyed. He started incredibly well
59.
In this match, but it seems to have gone a little bit flat.
Well, if he hadn't messed around with the miscount and then missing doubles, and you wonder if he was slightly distracted by that, he could have been 3-0 up in this one, and the game might have been very different. But he did, so he isn't, and he wasn't, and here we are.
Oh,
and here Chris Dobie is.
Perfectly timed.
140.
Well, that might do. Darrell, you would think, needs to match it, and he's not going to match it, and he might not even find a way into the treble from there.
60. Richard Guay, 110.
Treble 20. Now treble 18. Now double 18.
74.
He probably comes
160.
Back. And if he does, Darrell Gurney is in all sorts of bother because the world number two is already gone and the world number three might be very close behind tonight.
100.
Dobie pinned this double 36. To win the previous leg. This will take him one away from a super win.
Yeah, shot the seventh leg.
Against Christo. Super Chin.
8 leg is Darrell to throw first. Game on.
The crowd have been fantastic tonight. You just listen to them. And this sort of weird mist has descended in Sindelfingen. This sort of glass palast fog that you get.
Yeah, you want to be out there, don't you? Don't you?
Well, if the option is being out there with them or being here with you.
60.
Go on then. Off your pop.
All right then.
He actually has gone. And Darrell Gurney might be joining
140.
Him.
140.
Sooner rather than later, but he's trying to scrap.
97.
But that is scrappy.
45.
Scrappy, scrappy stuff indeed from Gurney. So there's an advantage in this leg, but it might be eliminated.
98.
I've not got a ticket.
No, no. Won't let you through.
No.
That jacket, isn't it?
Yeah. Plus, it's all got
125.
A little bit interesting here.
Yeah,
big
91.
Passage of play. 91 for Darrell Gurney. Does he look at two doubles? Chose not to, and Dobie has the chance to seal the deal here and now.
106.
Nearly took the 110 out. Treble 18. He's got a dart for the 106.
74.
Wow. Match dart missed.
It was well thrown, the width of the wire, denying Derby a 6-2 win. Yes. Darryl Gurney hangs on for now.
I think it's Chris to throw first.
I mean, we should have said, Dan, that the reason that you're not out there is because he wasn't a spare
game
seat.
On.
That would have been better PR, wouldn't it?
Yeah, probably.
You don't get much better PR for a tournament than some of the stuff we've seen already today.
This is true.
And some of the stuff that is coming up tonight, and some of the stuff that could take place over the next three legs here, because Derby has not got this match won yet, and he only has to cast his mind back to Austria when he took on Andrew Gilding and looked like he was going to be absolutely battered by Goldfinger, who then proceeded to miss the best part of 10 match darts, and Derby stole the win away.
81.
He has first-hand experience of seeing somebody seemingly cruising towards the finishing line and then throwing it away. So he has been warned.
55.
Andrew Gilding, who incidentally has just booked his place in the semi-finals of the Challenge Tour event going on right now.
Ooh.
He will play Tony Mitchell, Boris Koltsov and Cameron Menzies in the other last four match. Certainly names that have appeared on the European Tour stage as Gurney looks to fill it up, does fill it up. It's enough to leave a checkout.
It's only his second 180 in this game, Darryl Gurney. When he does start hitting them, he can hit them in clutches.
100.
He won't want to see one here, but if he can leave himself on a double, it will pile loads of pressure on Chris Derby.
I think Derby would love to see this first start with the treble 20. He doesn't want to have to be
80.
Manoeuvring past barricades. But that's what he might have to do. He manoeuvres right.
60.
He can't get wrong. It right. Yes, he does
52.
Indeed. Flicked off the flight, and Gurney could be launching a comeback.
Double 8 for the break. Double 4. He's done this before and missed all three.
Yeah.
But this time, the last dart rescues him. Break of throw. 5-4. Super chin throwing to level the match. Chris Derby has missed a dart to win it 6-2. He's missed a dart to win it 6-3. He shakes his head because he's not guaranteed he'll get any more darts to win it. Not against this man.
Gurney is not feeling as generous as Rob Cross was against Izvan earlier on, who missed 11 darts to beat Cross before finally falling over the line.
81.
It's looking likely that Darryl Gurney is going to force a last leg shootout here.
135.
Well, the one thing you would say for Chris Derby is that he's got a good temperament. He doesn't seemingly, he doesn't panic or tend to lose his rag or anything like that. Even if things are going against him, things have started to go against him in the last couple of legs. But we've seen him win a dart on the live stream and board, a game on the live stream board, throwing a 9-darter in a last leg decider this year. He might need a very special leg in the last leg of this one if he is going to knock out the players' champion.
Yeah, well, the dart double top was difficult because of the position of a blocker in the board. The dart double 16, there was not much wrong with, apart from it didn't go in.
Darryl Uguard, four.
A big thing wrong with it, though, isn't it?
Well, yeah, it's not ideal. But he hasn't looked nervy, that's the point. He might be feeling nervous now because Gurney has
Chris to throw first.
Pulled it back to 5 apiece from a deficit of 5-2. Derby has the darts and the decider, but Darryl has the momentum.
Well, it's been a long while since these two were involved in a close game. Derby was a convincing winner on the Pro Tour earlier this year. The two meetings at the Players' Championship Finals the last couple of years have been one-sided affairs. Wins both for Darryl Gurney. Their first meeting did go to a last-leg decider. That's more than 4 years ago, and they're very different players nowadays. Darryl Gurney's a two-time major champion.
42.
And I think that Darryl Gurney has now become the overwhelming favourite to see this one out.
100.
Derby needs to dig in, to dig himself out.
Oh, maybe there is panic there.
45.
Panic with the capital P. Does Darryl know? Does Gurney know that he's got him?
Oh, 131.
Superb. Really superb. Well, Darryl Gurney could do nothing when Chris Dobie was throwing at double 18
for a 6.
Sorry, double 16 for a 6-2 win.
It
will be Dobie that is powerless now. All he can do is hit and hope.
100.
The world number 3 has got there for a reason. He is very, very difficult to beat. But it is not impossible.
Well, Chris Dobie has missed 2 darts to win this match. But now Darryl Gurney has missed 3. It's the same shots. Is he going to cause himself the same problem? He's got more space to the right this time. And he's over the top. And now both players on that stage have missed a hat-trick of darts to win this match.
3 darts in 3 separate legs have all gone begging for Chris Dobie. And now he's gone out of the tournament because the world number 3, Darryl Gurney, somehow squeaks through. And we'll take on either Max Hopp or Nathan Aspinall. You cannot get the smile off Super Chin's face. The Northern Irishman knows he has got away with murder in Sindelfingen.
Das ist nochmal gut gegangen für Darryl Gurney, für Super Chin. Er steht im Achtelfinale, macht einen 2-5 Rückstand wett. Und kommt dann doch noch irgendwie über die Ziellinie. Darryl, congratulations. Honestly, I didn't think you couldn't win that match when he was up 5-2. I thought it was done.
I still believe, but whenever I was, I think it was actually 5-3, I thought to myself, even though he's got the throw in the last leg, I play proper darts, I can come back at him. Okay. And obviously he missed 2 shots at 80, and he missed something else. But I hung in there, and in the last leg, couple legs, I was sitting on double probably after 12 darts and that. But once I was staying 3 darts at tops, I thought, he's going to finish this 80 now. But bit of luck, he missed it, and then I took it out. So a bit of luck is always needed. But I thought I played well whenever I was behind, even though Chris probably should have won the game.
Yeah. You're the number 3 in the world in the meantime. First time you're the number 3, the highest ranking you've ever had. Does it mean a lot to you?
Yeah, it means that there's 2 more players in the world better than me. But I feel like the first 6 months of Rob Cross, he was there and thereabouts. But in the last 6 months, he was phenomenal. He was unbelievable. But I believe I can catch him. And I believe I can get the number 2 in the world. But as for Michael, he's somewhere out in the sunset in Barbados, sitting back drinking cocktails. So for me, at one stage I'd love to be number 2 in the world, behind the best player in the world. But I'll keep on trying, keep on fighting, and I never give up on that game, and came away with a win.
Cool. See you tomorrow. Thank you very much. Darryl Gurney. die neue Nummer 3 der Welt, seine höchste Weltranglistenposition. Und er sagt, er hat vor, sich den Rob Cross in diesem Jahr noch